Welcome to EPG Parthshala on the subject Social Medicine and Community Health. I am Professor C.P. Mishra, working in the Department of Community Medicine, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. I shall be discussing the module Water Quality Standards and Their Monitoring and Surveillance. This module belongs to the paper Environmental Health. This has been developed by a team comprising of myself as principal investigator, Dr. V.M. Gupta, ex-professional head, Department of Community Medicine, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi, as paper coordinator. This module has been written by Dr. Amit Kaushik from Department of Community Medicine, Uttar Pradesh Rural Institute of Medical Sciences, SEFAI, Ottawa, Uttar Pradesh. And the content has been reviewed by Dr. J. Tandon, ex-professor and head, Department of Community Medicine, Institute of Medical Sciences, Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. The learning objectives that has been set for this module: number one, one should be able to enumerate different aspects of water quality, particularly with reference to drinking water. Understand microbial monitoring, able to describe surveillance of drinking water quality. We all know that water is the most basic and important natural resource available to man. There cannot be life without water. Water for the purpose of drinking is utmost important among all the form of water requirement. Thus, the water meant for drinking should not contain any harmful substance which may affect the health of individuals and should be acceptable to the consumers with regard to physical characteristics like its color, odor and taste. There should not be bacterial or chemical contamination of water and should be worth storing at household level. The risk of public health hazard is increased in case of failure of any single point of water supply system, which includes sources of water, treatment processes, storage and distribution systems. Although when they are in the large scale treatment process, extra chlorination is done, residual chlorine is kept at 0.5 ppm to take care of the problems, contamination that may occur through distribution systems and storage. Different aspects of drinking water quality. As per WHO, that is World Health Organization, water quality guidelines, different aspects of drinking water quality are: one is microbial aspects that refers to bacteria or organisms, virus; chemical aspects; radiological aspects; acceptability aspects in terms of taste, odor and appearance. Microbial aspects: as far as microbial aspect of drinking water quality is concerned, the greatest risk to health is imposed by fecal matter of human as well as animals. Fecal matter can be a source of number of pathogenic microorganisms including bacteria, viruses, protozoa and helminths. Not only the pathogens from fecal matter but other microbial hazards like guinea worm, which have been now eradicated from source waters, and legionella now in piped water distribution system, also associated with it. Attributable factors for the public health burden associated with consumption of contaminated water: 70 CBRT and incidence of illnesses associated with pathogens, their infectivity and the population exposed. Various routes involved are ingestion. One of the important thing is like Campylobacter species, Escherichia coli, Salmonella species, Shigella species, Vibrio cholera, Hepatitis A virus, Hepatitis E virus, Entamoeba histolytical, and Giardia intestinalis. Inhalation, adenoviruses, enteroviruses, Legionella pneumophila, or by direct contact during bathing. Acanthamoeba species, Burkholderia, Pseudomallei, Leptospira species. Reference pathogens identified to represent bacteria, viruses, protozoa, and helminths. Criteria for identification: waterborne transmission is an established route of infection. Availability of data to perform quantitative microbial risk assessment, including data on dose response relationship in humans and disease burden. Occurrence in source waters, persistence in the environment, sensitivity to removal or inactivation by treatment process, infectivity, incidence and severity of disease. Viruses, more difficult to remove by physical process such as filtration. They can persist for long periods in water and quite infective to disinfection. Rotaviruses, enteroviruses, noroviruses have been identified as potential reference pathogens. Bacteria, pathogens that is most sensitive to inactivation by disinfection. Dose response models are available for Vibrio, Campylobacterium E. coli, 0157, Salmonella and Shigella. Protozoa, they are least sensitive to inactivation by chemical disinfection. Dose response models available for Giardia and Cryptosporidium. Quantitative microbial risk assessment, QMRA, systematically combines available information on exposure, the number of pathogens ingested, and dose response models to produce estimates of the probability of infection associated with exposure to pathogen in drinking water. Microbial monitoring. Indicator organism is needed for monitoring. Criteria for fecal indicator: inversely present in feces of human and animals. Should not multiply in natural water. Should persist in water in a manner similar to fecal pathogens. And should be present in higher numbers than fecal pathogens. Should respond to treatment process in a similar fashion to fecal pathogens. Should readily be detected by simple, inexpensive cultural methods. Indicator organisms monitoring E. coli or thermotolerant coliforms is used as indicator of contamination of water with fecal matter. Total coliforms indicate the cleanliness and integrity of distribution system. Helicotrophic plate count indicates effectiveness of disinfection process and cleanliness and integrity of distribution system. Clostridium perfringensis is used to indicate the effectiveness of disinfection and physical removal processes. Enteric viruses as indicator of effectiveness of disinfection and physical removal process for viruses. Guideline values for verification of microbial quality. This is given by World Health Organization. Organism guideline value: all water directly intended for drinking E. coli or thermotolerant coliform bacteria must not be detected in any 100 ml of sample. Treated water entering the distribution system, E. coli or thermotolerant coliform bacteria must not be detected in any 100 ml sample. Treated water in the distribution system, E. coli or thermotolerant coliform bacteria must not be detectable in 100 ml of sample. Immediate investigation action must be taken if E. coli are detected. B. Although E. coli is the more precise indicator of fecal pollution, the count of thermotolerant coliform bacteria is an unacceptable alternative. If necessary, proper confirmatory test must be carried out. Total coliform bacteria are not acceptable as indicator of sanitary quality of water supplies, particularly in tropical areas where many bacteria of no sanitary significance can occur in almost all untreated supplies. C. It is recognized that in the great majority of rural waste supplies, especially in developing countries, fecal contamination is widespread. Especially under these conditions, medium-term targets for progressive involvement of water supply should be set. The second aspect is chemical aspects. The chemical constituents have ability to cause adverse health effects after prolonged periods of exposure, which some by a single exposure through massive accidental contamination of drinking water supply. Categorization of source of chemical constituents, source of is again World Health Organization, mainly five types: naturally occurring chemical constituents, industrial sources and human dwellings, agricultural activities related chemicals, water treatment or materials in contact with drinking water. Naturally occurring, found mostly in rocks, soils, and the effects of geological setting and climate. Eutrophic water bodies also influenced by sewage inputs and agricultural runoffs. Examples are arsenic, barium, boron, chromium, fluoride, selenium, chloride, hardness, hydrogen sulfide, iron, manganese, molybdenum, pH of water, sodium, potassium, sulfate, total dissolved solids. Industrial sources and human dwellings, mining, extractive industries and manufacturing and processing industries, sewage including a number of contaminants of emerging concern, solid beds, urban runoffs, fuel leakages and so on. Examples are beryllium, cyanide, 1,3-dichlorobenzene, 1,3-dichloroethane, 1,1-dichloroethane, di-2-ethylhexyl adipate, hexachlorobenzene, methyl tertiary butyl ether, monochlorobenzene, nitrobenzene, petroleum products, and trichlorobenzenes, 1,1,1-trichloroethane. A number of agricultural activities from manures, from fertilizers, intensive animal practices, and pesticides, they pollute water bodies. There are three types: inorganic, cadmium and mercury; organic, benzene, carbon tetrachloride, 1,2-dichlorobenzene, and nitric acid; non-pesticides, nitrates and nitrites. Nitrites, high level of nitrites indicate recent pollution, and high level of nitrate indicates old pollution or old contamination of fecal matter. Pesticides used in agriculture: aldicarb, aldrin, dieldrin, linden, methoxychlore, and so on. Materials in contact with drinking water, found as form of coagulants and also piping materials. Examples include material of water treatment, chlorine, monochloroamine, sodium, dichloroiso, cyanurate, disinfection by products, bromate, bromoform, chlorate, chloride, chloroform. Contaminants from pipes and fittings like antimony, copper, lead, nickel, vinyl chloride. Pesticides used in water, larvicides used in the control of insect vectors of disease. Examples are difluobenzone, methoprin, novaluron, primifos methyl, pyroxifen, and temifos. The guidelines for chemical guidelines values are, guidelines values are derived using two approaches: threshold chemicals, in case of many chemicals no adverse effect is observed below a certain dose known as threshold dose, and tolerable daily intake, TDI, tolerable daily intake should be calculated. Non-threshold chemicals, these are mainly genotoxic carcinogens. Models are used to develop guidelines values for those. These models compute an estimate of risk at a particular level of exposure along with upper and lower confidence limits. Tolerable daily intake It is an estimate of the amount of a substance in food and drinking water exposed on a body weight basis, milligram or microgram per kilogram of body weight, that can be ingested over a lifetime without a perceivable health risk and with a margin of safety. So, tolerable daily intake is calculated taking into account the lifetime risk without a perceivable health risk and with a margin of safety. Threshold chemicals are, for chemicals, a tolerable daily intake should be derived using the most sensitive endpoint as following. TDI is equal to NOAEL or LOAEL or BMDL, UFN or CSAF. Where NOAEL is no observed adverse effect level. LOAEL is lowest observed adverse effect level. BMDL, lower confidence limit on the benchmark dose. And UF means uncertainty factor and CSFA, chemical specific adjustment factor. So TDI takes into cognizance these values. The guideline value is then derived from TDI as follows. GV equal to TDI into BW into P by C, where BW is body weight, P is fraction of the TDI allocated to drinking water, and C is daily drinking water consumption. NOEL and LOEL, the NOEL is defined as the highest dose or concentration of chemical that causes no detectable adverse effect. And if NOEL is not available, LOEL, lowest observed dose or concentration of substance as which a detectable adverse effect occurs, may be used. When LOEL, lowest limit value, is used instead of NOEL, an additional uncertainty factor is normally applied. So this is the system why we are giving consideration to these values. Source of uncertainty in derivation of guidelines values are, source of uncertainty, interspecies variation, extrapolating from experimental animals to human, uncertainty factor is 1 to 10. Intraspecies variation, accounting for individual variations within humans, 1 to 10. And adequacy for studies of databases, 1 to 10. Nature and severity of effect, 1 to 10. So these are taken. Benchmark dose, if appropriate data are available for dose response relationship modeling, BMDLs are used as an alternative to NOAELs in calculating the health-based guideline values, benchmark dose. The benchmark or BMDL is the lower confidence limit of the dose that produces a small increase in the level of adverse effects. So, radiological aspects, risk of health to health may also occur due to presence of naturally occurring radionucleotides in drinking water. As far as radiological aspect is concerned, screening of drinking water should be done for GRAS alpha and GRAS beta radiation activity. Levels of screening values don't indicate any immediate risk to health, but it gives clue to for further investigation of water. Becquerel BQ, SI unit of radioactivity, which means one radioactive disintegration per second. In case of drinking water, it is expressed as BQ per liter. Effective dose, when radiation interacts with the body tissues and organs, the radiation dose received depends upon type of radiation, part of the body affected, and exposure pathway. The effective dose is expressed in SI units called sieverts or millisieverts. Guiding level of radionucleotides in drinking water can be calculated as following. GL, guiding level, is equal to IDC / hinge into Q, where guidance levels of radioactive nuclide in drinking water is BQ by per liter. IDC individual dose criterion equal to 0.1 MCSB year per year for this calculation. Hinge dose coefficient for ingestion by adults, that is MSB by BQ, and Q is equal to annual ingested volume of drinking water assumed to be 730 liters per year, equivalent to the standard World Health Organization drinking water consumption rate of 2 liters per day. steps, assessment methodology to control radionucleotide. And IDC individual dose criterion of 0.1 MSB from 1 year's consumption of drinking water is adopted. In initial screening, if the measured activity concentrations are below the screening levels of 0.5 BQ per liter for GRAS alpha activity and 1 BQ for GRAS beta activity, no further action is required. If any of the either GRAS alpha or GRAS beta activity exceeds the screening level, the concentration of individual radionuclides would be determined and compared with the guide dense levels. This further evaluation may indicate either no action is required or further evaluation is necessary before a decision can be made on the need for measurement to reduce the dose. Acceptability accepts taste, odor, and appearance. Depends mainly by three parameters: physical, chemical, and biological. Physical parameters, taste, odor, and water should be free from any objectionable taste and odors. Various natural, inorganic, organic, chemical, biological contaminants, sensory chemicals may give rise to taste and odor in water. Taste and odor may also develop during storage and distribution as a result of microbial activity. No guideline value has been proposed for taste and odor. Color. Drinking water should ideally have no visible color. Color in drinking water may be because of presence of colored organic matter, iron, and other metals, either as natural impurities or as corrosion products and contamination of water sources with industrial effluents. Color above 15 true color units can be detected in a glass or water. Level of color below 15 TCU are often acceptable to consumers. Turbidity. Suspended particles or colloid matter may cause the water to be turbid in the form of inorganic or organic matter or a combination of the two. Turbidity is measured by nephthalometric turbidity unit, and the naked eye can notice it above 4 NTU per T. Turbidity should not be more than 1 NTU and preferably much lower. Biological parameters, a number of diverse organisms, often of no public health importance but may produce taste and odor. Examples are actinomycetes and fungi, cyanobacteria and algae, invertebrate animals like life like freshwater shrimp, water louse, snails, and other mollusks. Chemical parameters, aluminium in excess of 0.1 to 0.2 mg per liter leads to consumer complaints because of deposition of aluminium hydroxide flocks. Ammonia, threshold odor, concentration of ammonia at alkaline pH is approximately 1.5 mg per liter, and a test threshold is 35 mg per liter for ammonium cation. Chloramines, no odor or test is detected for monochloramine at concentration between 0.5 to 1.5 mg per liter. Dichloramine between 0.1 to 0.5 mg produces slight and acceptable effects. Another threshold for trichloramine is 0.02 per liter. Chloride, test threshold for chloride ranges between 200 to 300 mg per liter. Chlorine, the test threshold for chlorine is below the health-based guideline value of 5 mg per liter. Copper, at levels above 5 mg per liter, copper also imparts a color and an undesirable bitter taste to the water. Dissolved oxygen, decreased dissolved oxygen in water encourages the microbial reduction of nitrate to nitrite and sulfate to sulfide. No health-based guideline value is recommended. High levels may lead to corrosion of metal pipes. Hardness, the test threshold for the calcium ion is in the range of 100 to 300 mg per liter, and that for magnesium is probably lower than that of calcium. Hydrogen sulfide, The test an ordered threshold for your hydrogen sulfide in water are estimated to be between 0.05 to 0.1 mg per liter. Iron does not produce any noticeable change in the test at concentration below 0.3 mg per liter, although turbidity and color may develop. Magnesium above 0.1 mg per liter magnesium in water supply causes an undesirable test. Sodium, test threshold for sodium is about 200 mg per liter. pH, the optimum pH is usually ranges from 6.5 to 8.5. Sulfate, the test threshold ranges from 250 mg per liter for sodium sulfate, 200 mg per liter for calcium sulfate. Total dissolved solids, the palatability of water with total dissolved solids below 600 mg is considered to be good, but above 1000 mg per liter water becomes unpalatable. Zinc, undesirable test in water is produced above the threshold concentration of about 4 mg per liter zinc sulfate. So, once we have discussed the different aspects of quality of water, now we will be switching over to surveillance of drinking water quality. Surveillance in relation to quality of drinking water quality means keeping a careful watch at all times from public health point of view over the safety and acceptability of drinking water supply. So there are two major issues that comes under the purview of surveillance. One is safety and second is acceptability of drinking water. Key elements are monitoring, sanitary survey, data processing, and evaluation. So, in surveillance procedure, we are monitoring, we are posting sanitary surveys, data processing, and evaluation. But the ultimate effect of or ultimate purpose of any surveillance activity is to, on top of monitoring, there should be an action component. So monitoring plus action makes it a surveillance activity. Remedial and preventive action, the last point, remedial and preventive action is very important, because if you don't do remedial and preventive action, it is a monitoring activity and it is not a surveillance activity. An institutional analysis is needed. Monitoring involves laboratory and field testing of water samples collected from various points in water supply system, including the source, water purification point, distribution systems, houses, and consumer ends. The Central Pollution Control Board is an apex body in the field of water quality management in India. The water quality monitoring was started in the year 1976 by Central Pollution Control Board with 18 stations on the Yamuna River. The program has gradually been extended. At present, there are 1,032 monitoring stations in the country spread over all important water bodies. Water sample is taken. The aim of collecting samples is for assessment of the quality of water from various sources and examination of physical, chemical, and bacteriological quality of water. At many places, we are doing the most probable number based on Magnitude chart, but there are other contaminants like chemical contaminants that have an important impact. Segregation of sampling point. Samples collected are representative of all the sources from which the water enters the system. Samples collected should be representative of the conditions at the most unfavorable places in the system, points of possible contamination like loops, reservoirs, low pressure zones, and so on. Sampling points should be uniformly distributed throughout the system. Many times we do sampling from when water passes through a city gradually, then the contamination increases. Samples should also be collected from reservoirs and reserve tanks. At least one sampling point should be there at the clean water outlet from each treatment plant. collection of water sample, sampling for bacteriological examination. For bacteriological examination, water samples should be collected in clean, sterilized, narrow mouth, neutral glass bottles with capacity of 250, 500 or 1000 ml. Colorless or pearl green colored bottles should be preferred, except in case of collecting samples for residual chlorine, where the dark colored bottles must be preferred. The bottles should have a ground glass stopper with an overlapping rim, and the stopper should be relaxed by an intervening strip of paper between the stopper and the neck of the bottle. The stopper and neck of the bottle must be protected by paper, parchment cover or thin aluminium paper. Sterilization of the bottle should be done in an autoclave at 1 kg per centimeter square pressure for 15 minutes. If the water from which a sample is collected contains residual chlorine or chloramine, add 0.2 ml of 10% sodium thiosulfate, sodium sulfate, to the bottle to neutralize these substances before the bottle is sterilized. Bacteriological examination is an important component, standard plate count. It is an empirical method to indicate the efficiency of coagulation, filtration and disinfection in water purification, and measures the viable aerobic and facultative anaerobic bacteria in water. Colonies that appear on nutrient agar after incubation at 37 degrees per 24 are counted. Test for coliforms. The number of coliform group may be estimated by multiple tube dilution method, presumptive test, confirmatory test and completed test or membrane filtration technique, and charts are available which can be taken into account to find most probable number. Multiple tube dilution test, MTD. In analysis of water, at least 3 milli dilutions of 5 tubes each dilution are used. McConkie's boat is used as a presumptive medium. Most probable number of coliform elements per 100 ml of sample water, which is estimated based on certain probability formulae, can be estimated from the number of tubes showing acid and gas. The MPN value for a given sample can be obtained using MPN tables, and this has been given, one table is given by McGrady chart. Presumptive test, a series of fermentation tubes are inoculated with samples of water, incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 to 48 hours and examined at the end of 24 hours for gas production. If there is no gas production, incubate for another 24 hours and examine again at the end of 48 hours. A possible presumptive test means gas formation any amount within 48 hours. If no gas formation occurs at the end of 48 hours, the test is considered negative. Confirmatory test. The test is performed using all primary fermentation tubes showing gas production at the end of 24 hours of incubation. The medium used in confirmatory test is brilliant green bile lactose broth. The positive confirmatory test is indicated by formation of any amount of gas at any point within 48 hours. Completed test, it may be applied to positive brilliant green bile lactose broth tubes. By measuring membrane filtration technique, by using membrane filtration technique, results can be obtained within 24 to 48 hours. Yam Indo broth is used as a medium in membrane filtration techniques. Members of coliform group are identified by formation of dark red colonies with a metallic sign with 24 hours of incubation. Chemical examination, the test that can be applied to assess the chemical quality of drinking water include for test for pH, color, turbidity, ammonia, chloride, chlorine demand of water, residual chlorine, toxic metals and pesticides. Bacteriological quality of water, biological unit quality can be assessed by monitoring for algae, fungi, yeast, protozoa, snails and so on. Sanitary survey. Sanitary survey is on the site inspection assessment of all conditions, applications and practices in water supply system which may lead to health hazards to consumers. This also gives us action points. Data processing and evaluation, the huge data generated by monitoring and sanitary survey is processed and analyzed, and information is elicited to be utilized by those involved in program planning to make improvements in ongoing program. remedial and preventive action. Remedial action was actions that are to be carried out to rectify the deficiencies after they are detected, and may include repairing and upgrading, spot source production, checking of flowing dosage, and use of safe alternative sources. Institutional analysis involves scrutiny of important functions like defective design, poor maintenance, ineffective supervision, inadequate training, inadequate staff, lack of infrastructural coordination, leading to deficiencies in water supply system. Thus, we have discussed what water quality has in terms of health of human being, what are the different aspects of water quality, and if you will contemplate water quality, then what are the various steps involved, and how surveillance policy can improve the quality of drinking water and indirectly the health of the human population. Thank you very much for visiting EPG Barcelona.